Chapter 46. I can't keep letting Anya's kiss me repeatedly. Anya's suddenly understood and felt perplexed. You stayed awake for this? Su Jian refused to admit. Of course not. In actual fact, initially, he happened to remember that it was Anya's 30th birthday the next day. Thus, he purposely reminded himself about it. At the beginning, he had wanted to use Anya's age to attack him as he was recently concerned about his age. However, after waiting for a while, this matter became an exciting little secret hidden in his heart. At the moment when the clock struck zero, he had forgotten his plan to attack Anya's. He only stole the chance to be the first to wish Anya's a happy birthday at the most perfect moment. Anya's looked at him deeply. Suddenly, his body moved and at the next moment, Su Jian was pressed under him. Hey! What are you? NNN. Anya's didn't kiss for long and soon released Su Jian. Su Jian panted slightly. He had yet to return to his senses when the man pressing him down on him said, "This is a return gift." Su Jian glared at him and said angrily, "I only want a $5 million check as my return gift. Your mom. If I knew the return gift would be so lame, I should have also wished for this for the annoying and god. At 30 years old you will have erectile dysfunction." Anya's ignored his angry words. He looked downwards with a deep expression. "Jian Jian, thank you." His expression was so gentle and his tone was so sincere that Su Jian froze momentarily. However, Su Jian soon came back to his senses and said helplessly, "Get off my body already. You are very heavy." Anya's lips raised. He turned over and laid at his side. Once he gained his freedom, Su Jian jumped to the other side of the bed immediately, distancing himself from Anya's. Seeing that Anya's was not making any movement, Su Jian soon relaxed. However, after a moment, he suddenly realized, "Why should I be afraid of this fellow? He was the one that forced a kiss on me." Thinking about this point, he suddenly came to a realization. Anya's forced a kiss on him again. Although it wasn't as shocking as the first time, Su Jian was still enraged. He couldn't win Anya's in a fight, and neither could he scold him. Su Jian felt aggrieved. Thinking about it, he suddenly pounced over. While Anya's had yet to react, he lowered his head and bit Anya's lip. Anya's. After successfully wounding Anya's and expecting that he would lose his image in front of everyone during his birthday party tomorrow, Su Jian's anger was vented and he quickly fell asleep. President An, whose lips was bitten, touched his slightly painful lips. He couldn't sleep for the night. Su Jian saw the wound on Anya's lip after waking up the next morning. Additionally, he also saw two dark circles under Anya's eyes. Su Jian thought, "Anya's is not doing well." He felt relieved. After breakfast, in order to prevent a misunderstanding like the previous time, Su Jian explained before everyone else got suspicious. Yesterday night, while Anya's was eating, he actually bit his mouth. "He is so careless." Anya's looked at him silently and didn't say anything. However, Anyaru stared at his brother's lips meaningfully. "Third brother, just how did you eat to be able to bit your upper lips?" After speaking, she even stuck out her teeth to test it out. Anya's still remained silent. Anyaru felt that she understood. By their side, the In parents looked at each other and roughly understood. Thus, Father An gave a small cough and said lovingly, "Xiao Jian." Su Jian hastily answered but suddenly had a bad omen. "Indeed," Father An continued, "seeing that you and Xiao's are so loving, we feel rest assured. Now that we're talking about this, when do the two of you intend to have a child?" Su Jian. Su Jian, who was still shocked about needing to have a child, was still out of his mind when Anyaru called him. "Third sister-in-law, Uncle Wang said that your dress and jewelry have arrived in your room. Won't you take a look?" Anyaru said with a smile. "What?" Su Jian was a little ignorant. "What dress and jewelry?" "It's for third brother's birthday party tonight." Anyaru smiled. "I have heard that third brother personally chose everything for you." Su Jian was totally unaware of this, so he was pulled by Anyaru into the room. While they were walking, Anyaru said, "Later on, a stylist will be coming over. Speaking of which, I'm looking forward to seeing how third sister-in-law will look like when you wear the dress. I wonder what type of dress third brother chose for you." After a while, the stylist really came. He helped Su Jian with his makeup and his hairstyle. Though Su Jian was unwilling in his heart, He could only sit obediently to let the stylist do his job. Fortunately, the result was good. Su Jian looked at himself in the mirror and raised his brows. The girl in the mirror with long and slightly curled hair dressed in a white yarn dress also showed a weird expression. Su Jian turned around and at this moment, the door was opened. Su Jian tilted his head slightly to look, but he saw An Yaz walking in. Lifting his eyes to look over, An Yaz's sight paused. The stylist by the side smiled. I wonder, how does third young master think about it? An Yaz's sight landed on Su Jian. He said, not bad. The stylist smiled and retreated. The room was left to An Yaz and Su Jian. An Yaz did not look away and kept looking at Su Jian. Su Jian felt uncomfortable under his stare. He retreated unconsciously. However, that one step caused him to stagger. I really admire the majority of females. Just how do they walk as if they are flying when they wear high heels? Su Jian complained in his heart. An Yaz went forward immediately to support him and asked with concern, what's wrong? Are the heels not fitting? Su Jian shook his head. Number. The heels are too high. I'm not used to it. An Yaz said, you should be able to get used to it. After a while, but still be careful. Su Jian moved his legs and worriedly asked, what if I fall down in at the party? An Yaz replied, just stand back up. Su Jian, looking at the round eyes staring at him, An Yaz couldn't control his smile. It's okay. I will help you then. Su Jian thought, Humphrey, this is your birthday party anyway. If I fall, it's your face that will be lost. Thinking like this, Su Jian was no longer worried. An Yaz rubbed his hair gently and asked, do you like it? Su Jian was stunned. Like what? An Yaz held his shoulder and gently turned him around to face the mirror. Do you like the clothes? Su Jian coughed lightly. I feel that the necklace looks the best. In actuality, not only the necklace, but he also felt that the earrings and bracelet were beautiful. This was because you could tell that they were very expensive with one glance. An Yaz held his shoulder from behind. Looking at him in the mirror, An Yaz smiled. It's good that you like it. After hesitating for a moment, Su Jian couldn't control himself and asked, will all these belong to me after the party? An Yaz smiled. Naturally, immediately, a large smile appeared on Su Jian's face. Turning around, he faced An Yaz and said, Yaz, thank you. Looking at the little girl's bright eyes, An Yaz's heart softened. Looking down, he noticed the other's empty finger and remembered an important matter. He took out a small velvet box. A simple and elegant ring could be seen in it after opening the box. An Yaz pulled Su Jian's left hand over and carefully slipped the ring onto his ring finger. When he was done putting on the ring, Su Jian withdrew his hand with a whiz. He held his hand in front of his face and observed it carefully. This ring looks very expensive as well. Su Jian asked happily, is this for me as well? An Yaz replied, this is our wedding ring. Saying so, he raised his left hand. On his ring finger was a wedding ring of the same design. Su Jian unconsciously stretched out his hand and placed it on An Yaz's hand for comparison. He thought, a male ring is still the best. It looks so much bigger. An Yaz took the chance to hold his hand. Su Jian froze. What are you doing? An Yaz held his hand and headed out. The party is starting. Let's go. Thien's family status in the city was not low. An Yaz was the third young master of the An family, as well as the president of CMI. Thus, many guests attended his 30th birthday party. The guests consisted of people from major companies that worked with CMI as well as important figures that had a personal friendship with An Yaz. Additionally, there were sons and daughters of families that were friends of the An family. Su Jian did not know anyone. However, when he saw Jian, his eyes lit up. To think that they could even invite Queen Jian. An Yaz sure is highly regarded. Su Jian remembered that Jian was An Yaz's idol. Thinking about the fact that An Yaz could actually invite his idol to his house for his birthday party, Su Jian was once again renewed of his understanding of a rich man. When the party started, as usual, there was a talk. Su Jian did not pay attention to what An Yaz said. His two eyes kept looking at Jian. He wasn't sure if Jian would perform for that old man An Yaz, but maybe she'd sing a song. However, he still planned out everything. He would ask for Jian's autograph later. For such a famous celebrity, this was such a rare chance. However, he did not have an autograph book with him, And neither did he have Jian's picture. Looks like he would have to remember to ask the housekeeper uncle to print a few pictures of Jian later. Su Jian was thinking whether he should print 5 or 10 pictures when he suddenly heard Yaz's voice. Jian, Jian? Su Jian came back to his senses. He looked over and saw Yaz smiling, holding his hand out towards him. Are we going to start dancing? Su Jian was a little ignorant. He subconsciously took his hand. With a pull, Su Jian's waist was hugged by Yaz. Su Jian looked up slightly. Yaz was also looking down at him. His voice was as gentle as his eyes. Don't be afraid, leave everything to me. Su Jian placed one hand on his shoulder, while his other rested obediently in Yaz's hand. He strictly and softly reminded, remember to hold me tight later. I'm still not used to the heels. I'm worried that I will fall. Yaz nodded his head silently. The two began to dance with the melodious music and the guests watched. Deep within his heart, Su Jian was still a little nervous. After all, other than the time where his teacher painted his face red during Children's Day when he was in primary school and made him perform, he had never performed in front of someone else ever since. Su Jian counted the beat in his heart. In, out. He was dancing seriously and carefully, so he did not notice the originally small distance between him and Yaz gradually become smaller. Jian, Jian, look at me, Yaz suddenly said. Su Jian looked up at him ignorantly. The other person's eyes were dark and deep, and he could vaguely see his own shadow. Yaz's head suddenly stooped down. Su Jian was surprised and struggled instinctively. However, Yaz suppressed his struggle. At the same time, Yaz held his tongue. Su Jian. Fortunately, Su Jian remembered that there were still people around. Everyone was still looking at them. Your mom. Why didn't Yaz not pay attention to this? Forget about being kissed privately, he's now kissing in public. Su Jian wept without tears, but he did not resist in the slightest. How unlucky to have to act lovingly. Su Jian's body turned stiff, but he ultimately closed his eyes obediently. Then, he felt the hand holding his waist slightly tighten. Initially, Su Jian was still thinking, I can't keep letting Yaz kiss me repeatedly. Looks like I have to charge Yaz for special actions. However, after a while, Su Jian felt his body soften and his mind was dazed. The soft music flowed by his body, as if softening the whole place. There were many people around him, looking. However, Su Jian gradually could no longer feel them. His hand slowly moved up to hug Yaz's neck. How should I say this? This feels quite comfortable. Chapter 47, Hubby, where is your phone? Help me take a photo of Queen Jin Dai. When he was released, Su Jian's legs did not have any strength. If it wasn't for the fact that Yaz was holding onto him, he probably wouldn't be able to stand properly. Returning back to his senses, Su Jian did not dare to look at the people around him. He buried his head silently into Yaz's shoulder. Lowering his voice and wearing a stiff smile, he gritted his teeth and said, this wasn't in the practice. Yaz held him. His expression was so gentle that it could score full marks for acting. He said softly, we don't have to practice this. Su Jian, after being pulled around to greet the guests by Yaz, Su Jian finally calmed down. However, when he saw Yaz holding onto a glass of red wine for himself while passing a cup of juice to him, Su Jian felt depressed. Just what did he do when he was drunk to cast such a big shadow on Yaz? A female guest beside them couldn't control herself and glanced at Su Jian's belly. She laughed heartily. Is third young mistress pregnant? After saying this, not only did the nearby guest look over, even Jian, who was slightly further away, looked over with a stiff expression. Su Jian was stunned and immediately clarified, no, no. He knocked on Yaz secretly, signaling him to clear the misunderstanding. Yaz did not answer the guest's question. He only said, Jian, Jian's body is not well and is temporarily not suited for drinking alcohol. The people around showed an ambiguous understanding smile and complimented, third young master and third young mistress sure are loving. With a stiff face, Su Jian replied with a ha-ha. Fortunately, they were soon in front of Jian. This was Su Jian's first time interacting so closely with a celebrity, so he felt a little excited. He was staring at Jian so much that it looked as if his eyes were lights shining on her. Honestly speaking, Queen Ji looked very pretty. Her expression looked very gentle and easily left a good impression on someone else. In the past, Su Jian would have kneeled and licked his goddess foot. But now, since Jian was an Yaz's idol, Su Jian's impression of her couldn't help but drop. Though his relationship with an Yaz has improved, they were still love rivals. To add on, An Yaz had just taken advantage of him in front of everyone earlier. His anger had yet to dissipate. Naturally, he wouldn't look fondly upon anything An Yaz related. An Yaz's face, hateful. An Yaz's smile, hypocritical. An Yaz's goddess, argh, just another ordinary pretty woman. Xiao's, happy birthday. Jian looked at An Yaz with a smile, her voice gentle and moving. Xiao's, such an intimate addressing. Su Jian's ear moved, and his gossiping soul came into life with a whiz. An Yaz's expression did not change. Thank you. Jian smiled. You're once again older by another year. Time sure flies. Jian's voice carried a trace of sadness and sounded very moving. However, when Su Jian heard it, he felt awkward. He looked at An Yaz silently and thought, older by another year. Why does it sound like a mother talking to her son? This person here is a 30-year-old uncle and all right. An Yaz replied with an and did not say anything else. On the other hand, Jian was slightly dejected. She continued, I have been working overseas these past few months. I did not expect you to be already married. Su Jian stood beside them dedicatedly and showed an understanding smile. However, his ear was perked up, listening to all the potential gossip. To be honest, what Queen Ji just said seems to carry too much information. An Yaz looked at her and spoke slowly, I also never expected that. Pausing for a moment, he continued, I would meet Jian Jian. Su Jian wasn't sure if he was just seeing things, but he felt that Jian's expression seemed to have stiffened. Fortunately, he didn't have to be invisible again. Since he was mentioned, he openly greeted Jian. Hello Queen Ji. Jian looked at him with the same gentle expression. Hello. Xiao's and I have known each other ever since we were young and we have a good relationship. So, you can just call me Jian. Known each other ever since you were young. Have a good relationship. Su Jian silently felt that the information was too much. However, he kept a dignified image. Hello, my name is Su Jian. After exchanging a few more words, Su Jian felt that the mood was appropriate. So he asked, I like your work very much, may I take a picture with you? Jian was not surprised. She gave An Yaz a glance before smiling, I never expected to gain another fan. This is my honor. Su Jian blurted, I'm not a fuss. Seeing that Jian's expression changed, he realized that he had said something wrong. Feeling vexed, he immediately added, actually, it's like this. In the past, Yaz seemed to like you very much. I'm now married to Yaz. Whatever he likes, I will like as well. With this additional sentence, the expressions of the two people beside him seemed to look bad. Su Jian looked at this person, then he looked at the other person. He didn't understand what was going on, but he knew he had said something wrong. In order to lift the mood, he asked Jian again, may I take a picture with you? Jian nodded her head. Su Jian knocked An Yaz gently and saw An Yaz looking over cluelessly. He gave Jian an awkward smile and turned towards An Yaz. Hubby, where is your phone? Help me take a photo of Queen Jin Dai. An Yaz took out his phone silently. How do you want to take it? Su Jian had already run towards Jian's side. He placed his hands on Jian's shoulder as if they were naturally familiar with each other and moved his face closer to Jian's. He said, I want a large face image. Jian. An Yaz silently took two pictures. Su Jian took over the phone to take a look. He felt that the pictures weren't bad and was very happy. He let Jian have a look and said sincerely, thank you. Jian looked at the phone and saw the screen being completely occupied by two large faces. Also, her face, which could not be considered large, looked like a silver plate when placed beside the small face of the girl beside her. Jian said, this picture doesn't seem good, why don't we take another one? Su Jian thought she was being polite, so he immediately said, no need, it looks good. I like it very much. Jian. Su Jian thought for a moment and asked Jian again, may I get your autograph as well? Jian did not fail to give a smile. Of course. That's great, Su Jian said happily. However, I don't have a pen with me now. Can I find you later? Jian's smile finally had a trace of unnaturalness. Okay. Yaz had been staying quiet next to them. Even after Jian said, "Please excuse me," he only looked at her back with a deep expression. Following him, Su Jian looked over as well and lamented, "You have good taste. Queen Ji's figure is indeed good. Slim waist, straight legs, and buttocks. Of course, it would be better if her chest was larger." Yaz furrowed his brows. "Did someone tell you something?"
"What? No."
Su Jian froze. Looking at Yaz with an awful expression, he asked, "What? You're unhappy even after I complimented your idol?"
"Idol?"
Yaz was stunned.
"Is she not?"
Su Jian continued, "When I talked about her the last time, weren't you very unhappy? However, I did not expect that the two of you to have known each other since childhood. Previously, I even thought that you paid her to specially invite her to perform for you." Yaz never expected for Su Jian to have such a misunderstanding, but he did not explain. He would tell Su Jian the matter between him and Jian eventually, but he did not intend to do so now. Su Jian suddenly asked, "About what time will this party end?"
Yaz replied, "It will take a while more."
"What's wrong?" Su Jian made a bitter face. "Wearing high heels is very tiring." Yaz wrapped his hand around his waist.
"Is it better if you lean onto me?"
Su Jian tried leaning on him before he said in confusion, "It doesn't seem to make a difference." The two of them were clinging on to each other closely when laughter suddenly erupted behind them. "Sister-in-law and Xiao's sure have a good relationship." Dot. Su Jian looked behind and a familiar face appeared in his sight.
"Yilang?"
Su Jian exclaimed in surprise. Yaying smiled. "Sister-in-law can call me second brother." After he finished, he looked towards Yaz.
"Sorry, I had something on so I came late."
"Little brother, happy birthday." Although Yaz's facial expression did not change much, it was obvious that when he looked at someone he was close with, the expression in his eyes was gentle.
"Thank you."
Yaying was obviously more interested in his sister-in-law than his own brother, thus he looked at Su Jian and smiled. "Sister-in-law is very pretty tonight." Su Jian felt a little moved, thinking that he would be able to meet two celebrities that he could only watch through the screen in one night. He studied Yaying carefully and realized that he really did look similar to Yaz. However, he was born with lifted eyes, with eyebrows containing a smile. Compared to Yaz, who only had one plain expression, he looked more friendly. In addition, he wasn't sure if it was because Yaz looked more mature and dressed in black suit, but compared to Yaying, who kept up with the latest fashion trends, Yaz looked more like the elder brother. Facing Yaying's compliment, Su Jian was very calm.
"Thank you, second brother."
Yaying smiled. "I've heard from Xiao's that sister-in-law is my fan." In just one night, he was labeled as a fan by two famous celebrities. Su Jian felt a little absurd. However, he recalled that he had once carelessly told Yaz that he was Yilang's fan nonsensically. However, it was unexpected that Yaz would actually tell Yaying about it.
"Xiao's said that you adore me, so he asked me to treat you better."
Su Jian was really surprised this time. Previously, when he said that he liked Yilang nonsensically, he saw that Yaz's expression wasn't too happy. However, he did not expect that Yaz would actually remember that matter and even told his second brother to treat him better. Su Jian felt a little perplexed, but he was clear about the warmth he felt. Feeling slightly moved, Su Jian instinctively raised his hand, trying to put it around Yaz's shoulder. However, when he stretched out his hand, he realized that his body was now shorter than Yaz by a lot. He couldn't put his hand around Yaz's shoulder at all. In desperation, he could only hold on to Yaz's arm. However, Yaz didn't think much about it. He thought that Su Jian was just tired from the high heels, so he silently let Su Jian lean against him. On the other hand, Yaying smiled. "Is this the legendary showing affection?" Su Jian thought in his heart. "Second brother, your eyes sure are bright. You can see the truth with just a glance." Su Jian had a better impression of Yaying now. He felt that although Yilang was pretty famous, he wasn't arrogant at all. Although he was a man, it wasn't bad. Thus, Su Jian could finally relax. Hugging Yaz's arm, he joked around with Yaying. "I wonder when second brother will bring a sister-in-law back to show your affection?"
Though he asked casually, he actually had a reason for asking. He wanted to know whether the recent hot news Yi Liang abandoned Lin Shimai for a night date with artist Qin Yanyang on the microblogging site was real or not. Yaz smiled. I'm still young. There's no rush. While Su Jian sighed saying, haha, my idol sure is shameless, he looked towards the innocent uncle and who once again had salt rubbed into his wound. Yaz silently said, second brother. 2 days ago, mother seemed to have asked the aunt of the Sun family out for a meal. Yaheng felt his head aching. Sun family? I've never heard of an unmarried daughter from the Sun family. Yaz replied, from what I have heard from mother, the maternal family of that aunt seems to have a pretty good niece. Yaheng held his forehead. Why did mother suddenly have such a hobby? Su Jian finally understood what they were talking about. Mother An was actually setting Yaheng up for a blind date. To think that a celebrity would have to attend a blind date too, especially for someone like Yi Liang who was so popular among females. Su Jian was very interested. Hearing Yaheng's question, he interrupted, mother seems to be watching an idol drama recently. 2 days ago, she even made me watch 2 episodes with her. The story seems to be about the marriage between an idol and a woman. Something about marrying first before developing their love later on. Yaheng, Su Jian said, why not have second brother bring Qin Yanyang back? If mother sees that you already have a girlfriend, she won't make you go on blind dates. Su Jian's expression was honest and sincere, looking like he was not holding any ill intentions. Yaheng showed a wry smile. Sister-in-law saw the news too? To be honest, I'm not very close to Qin Yanyang. However, I'm friends with her boyfriend, Su Jian. Why do I feel that the information is too much? Yaheng looked at Yaz. Aren't you and elder brother at home? Why does mother always think about me? Yaz replied, because there's only you to think about now. Yaheng was startled for a moment. Suddenly, he scrutinized Su Jian for a moment before looking at Yaz, feeling interested. Have you really gotten over it? The matter between him and Jian was not new to Yaheng. Thus, Yaz could immediately understand what he was trying to say. He replied simply, I'm already married to Jian Jian. Su Jian couldn't understand what the two of them were talking about. Looking between the two of them, he suddenly saw Yaheng smiling brightly. That's good. I wonder when can I be an uncle? Su Jian almost wanted to flip the table. Why is this topic mentioned so frequently? Fortunately, he did not have a bulging belly. If he had one, that would probably be treated as a fact. Previously, he had not think much about this issue. Now that it had been frequently mentioned, he finally started thinking about it. He was now a woman. He would eventually have to give birth. When he was still a man, he was actually envious of one thing about being a woman. The child that they gave birth to would definitely be theirs. Unlike being a man, their child could actually be from another man. Now that he could do what he was envious of, instead of feeling happy, he felt tortured. When he first became a woman, he felt that the worst thing that could happen was to be done by a man. However, after today, he actually felt that being done by a man wouldn't be that hard to accept, because he felt that seeing himself pregnant and giving birth to a child was the worst nightmare. While Su Jian was dying from depression, Yaz couldn't help but give him a glance before answering Yaheng. Jian Jian is still young. Su Jian gave an awkward laugh, revealing some of his teeth. Looking at Yaheng, he nodded. Yes, I'm still young. There's no rush. Pausing for a moment, he said in revenge, second brother is older than Yaz. This matter can wait till second brother's blind date is successful. Yaheng smiled wryly. I didn't expect that sister-in-law would be so concerned about my lifetime event. Su Jian said naturally, because I'm second brother's loyal fan. Yaheng replied, wouldn't the fans wish that I stay single forever? Su Jian said, how can I be such a narrow-minded fan? I will definitely wish for second brother to have a successful blind date soon. Yaheng looked at Su Jian, feeling more interested. Pondering for a moment, he suddenly looked solemn. Sister-in-law, can you do me a favor? Su Jian was stunned. What favor? Yaheng solemnly said, help me think of a way to change the TV drama that mother is watching. Choose a marriage is torture and bliss type of drama, or choose one that shows that being single is good. Yaz, Su Jian replied, I will try my best. Oh yes, second brother, please give me your autograph later. An Yihing gentlemanly smiled. No problem. Coincidentally, the housekeeper uncle happens to be walking past them. Su Jian busily stopped him. Uncle Wang, are the photos ready? Previously, he wanted to print Jian's photo. Then, he recalled that Yilang would be coming as well, so he decided to ask the housekeeper to print both of their photos. However, since he played a small role in the birthday party, he couldn't leave. Therefore, he asked Jimingfei, who happens to be beside him, to help him tell the housekeeper. Though, he wasn't sure if Jimingfei had passed on his message. When the housekeeper heard his words, he smiled. Third young mistress, everything is ready. Once he finished his sentence, he asked someone to take out the photos that Su Jian had wanted. After a while, Su Jian got the photos. Seeing the two separate packages of photos with their names written on the exquisite bags, Su Jian felt very satisfied. However, An Yihing was shocked by the thick stack of photographs passed over by Su Jian. I have to sign all of these? Su Jian had secretly checked. The price of Yilang's and Guiyan's signatures online weren't cheap. Thus, he simply printed 200 photos of Yilang in one shot. Su Jian looked at Yilang with a smile. Second brother, I'm troubling you. An Yihing. Author's notes. I think I will post another chapter tonight, but I can't be sure when I will do it. It'll probably not be too early. If it's too late, please do not wait. There's work and school tomorrow. Maybe I shouldn't have mentioned this cruel fact. Also, thank you Mo Yin, Loveless and Kangza for the king ticket. Hugs. Other than that, I still want to waste some time. Well, it's like this. In the comments, I saw someone saying that my story is newbie. Here, this author would like to say solemnly, this story is indeed a newbie. Not only that, it's funny. This author's role is being silly and funny. There won't be any soul-stirring development. It's only a slice of life about the two protagonists. There won't be any novel plot as well. There will only be more melodramatic development. That is the ever-so-common plotline. Why did I write a slice of life? Because this author has a bad taste. Why choose such a common plot? Haha, of course it's because this author loves common plotlines. For example, the plots that we have are amnesia, contracted marriage, falling in love after marriage, overbearing president falling in love, forever confused female protagonist, male protagonist that always force a kiss, female side character is often a villainous, male side characters after often good, male protagonist is very doting on female protagonist or male protagonist often finds it hard to maintain self-control, facepalm. Of course, there will not be any complicated plots as well, because this story is only about adapting. There's no complicated plot at all, just a slow love. Naturally, there won't be any battle of brains, because this author's intelligence is around the same as Jian Jian. Ugh. I feel that for those that have read till this point are probably already aware of this fact and feel that this author can no longer be saved. Ha ha ha. Solemn face actually, this author can write in different styles as well. Thus, I have decided to spoof a story about President An and Jian Jian's previous life today, silently admitting, all of this was dug out by this lazy author selectively from a file called Pit that was covered in dust after many years. As President An and Jian Jian are still males in their previous lives, it will be a story. For those that cannot accept two male doing whatever, please stop scrolling down, or else, your eyes will suffer. There are three versions, choose whichever you like. First, palace version. Let's introduce the setting first. He was the prince of the former dynasty. As for him, he is the new emperor. The two men had known each other since their younger days and were good friends. Unfortunately, the latter ruined the former's country and owed the former a lot. He had hurt the other too much. When the latter finally realized his mistake, the former was already ill beyond cure. He was maddened by despair, ignoring everyone's objections. He crowned the former as the empress. However, heaven did not fulfill his wish. Ultimately, they could not live together till old age. The storyline, Su Jian died in the spring. It was the spring season, the flowers were blooming, the grasses were growing, and warblers were flying about. The yang flowers were falling like snow, floating in the sky. At the waterside of the imperial garden, An Yaz was hugging the weak Su Jian, accompanying him to watch the beautiful sight of spring and the green willow. As Su Jian's lips were a pale white, but the smile on his face was as bright as always. I suddenly recalled many things about our teenage days. An Yaz's heart ached unbearably, but he didn't show it on his face. His eyes only showed a gentle smile. Is that so? What did Jian Jian remember? The two of them reminisced about their younger days. As they whispered, it was as if the past years had flown by with the spring breeze, and were then carried far away by the wind. However, it seems that I could not fulfill the wish of my younger days ultimately. Su Jian sighed gently. An Yaz's arm that was hugging him stiffened, but his voice still sounded gentle. What wish? Whatever you wish for, I will help you fulfill it. Su Jian blinked and smiled slyly. During my younger days, I always wished to marry you as my wife. An Yaz was stunned. Although it has reversed now. And I've become your empress. But in my heart. I'm still not resigned to this. Su Jian's eyes that looked at An Yaz deepened and his voice was as light as snow. As, if I want you. To be my empress. In the next life, are you. Willing? The rain poured continuously on the palace walls. The dazzling painted walls and beautiful tiles gradually eroded, and the beautiful faces eventually aged. Yet, even after a long time had passed, there were still old ladies secretly talking about the scene from that day. That day, the empress died in the arms of the emperor. The emperor hugged the empress' body and sat by the waterside for the whole day. Everyone in the palace distanced themselves. No one saw the expression on the emperor's face. Only the pure white yang flower was floating about looked a bit like tears. According to history, the emperor reigned the country for 40 years. The country experienced lasting peace and had a flourishing new generation. After 20 years, the emperor collapsed and was buried alongside Empress Su, second, Yuxia version. The moon was as round as a mirror, looking very lonely up in the sky. Su Jian sat quietly beneath the tree. Due to the night breeze, the flower petals floated into the air seemingly looking like a flower rain. It was already spring once again. He still remembered that day in the flower forest, with that person was dressed in white with a long sword. His posture was elegant. As the flower petals floated about like rain, he looked like a celestial being. Today, spring had come once again. The flowers were still present, but that person wasn't there. Su Jian's heart ached. Picking up the wine jar, he ruthlessly drank a mouthful of wine. A flower petal floated downwards slowly. Stretching out his hand, Su Jian caught the petal in his palm. The cold moonlight glimmered on the flower petals. Suddenly, a faint voice sounded in Su Jian's ear. At that time, it was also nighttime with the same full moon. Under the moonlight, that person looked at him and spoke with a relaxed voice. You are my wife. Naturally, my life will be complete with you. Su Jian's eye was suddenly scalding hot. He could not help but continue gulping down the wine, with some of it spilling out of his mouth as it flew down his neck. As, you said I made your life complete. But did you know, if you are not around, Su Jian's life can no longer be complete. Third, fantasy version. A brief introduction. In this previous world story, Jian Jian is the merman king while president and is a supreme demon. Why is this setting so chunabiu and so funny? Ha ha ha. The storyline, the merman king looked up abruptly. You don't want to keep me in captivity? Seeing the cold look of the supreme demon who didn't look like he was joking, the merman king shivered with fear in his heart. However, he smiled on the surface. Your majesty, this joke is indeed interesting. The supreme demon laughed eerily. Do you think that I'm joking? Before finishing his words, a brilliant light formed in his hands. Slowly, the light started spreading out like a lotus blooming. The light stretched out and turned into the shape of a web, slowly spreading out. The merman king exclaimed in surprise, you're really trying to capture me? The supreme demon laughed without saying anything. Suddenly casting his hands downwards, the light web suddenly moved towards the merman king to capture him. The merman king jumped away and screamed, you're crazy. However, he saw the brilliant light that was trying to capture him rushing towards him. He maneuvered anxiously, trying to avoid the brilliant light. However, that brilliant light seemed to be alive and continued chasing after him. Seeing that he could not avoid it, the merman king changed his mind. He raised and interlocked his hands, placing his hands in front of his chest while quickly whispering an incantation. However, The brilliant light did not stop at all and was still rushing towards him. The Merman King did not panic. His lips moved slightly while chanting. Seeing that the brilliant light was already closing in, the King of Sharks still did not avoid it, as if wanting the brilliant light to come towards him. The brilliant light did not stop and continued rushing towards him. When it was right before the Merman King, the brilliant light covered his whole body. However, the brilliant light unexpectedly stopped. Then, it dissipated as it exploded. Although it was only for a moment, the explosion, which spread out like a firework, illuminated the originally beautiful face of the Merman King, making it more beautiful and unmatchable. The Merman King looked at the man that wasn't too far away with a smile. However, his heart couldn't help but clench. In his panic, he had used a magic spell from the Merman tribe to fight against the brilliant light. The spell was difficult to cast in the first place, and to add on, the fact that he used it when all his spiritual power was lost made it even more dangerous. Although he was fortunate to be able to avoid the brilliant light using all his efforts, he was now very weak and the man before him would not let him off. If he attacked again, he would have no way of retaliating. The Supreme Demon wasn't surprised when he saw the Merman King counter his spell. Instead, a trace of smile seemed to form in his eyes. However, that smile was very cold, and the Merman King's heart froze in fear. Thinking about the fact that the man before him would really capture the powerless him, the Merman King panicked internally. He faintly said, "Your Highness, I have no further interest in continuing this game with you." After he had finished speaking, he turned to leave. He had no desire in staying any longer in this strange place before this cold person. However, he heard the man behind him laughing coldly. "You wish to leave?" The man suddenly appeared before him and a brilliant light flashed forth. The Shura Knife One was actually unsheathed and coming sharply towards him. The Merman King did not expect that he would be so obsessed to actually use the Shura Knife that could not be easily used to try and capture himself. In his heart, he was very shocked. He had experienced the might of this ancient magical weapon before. Even at full strength, he might not even be able to block its attack. And not to mention now, when he had already lost his powers. Seeing the Shura Knife approaching, he could not block it. His remaining power was barely able to maintain his current physical form. Under the crisis, he inadvertently caught a glimpse of the clear water at the side. His heart moved and he abruptly leapt into the large lake. As his body entered the water, his two legs transformed into a fish tail. His silver scales shone brightly, looking very beautiful and extraordinary. The Merman King swam deep into the water and in the next moment, he could no longer be seen. The Supreme Demon laughed coldly. The Shura Knife did not pause its attack and went straight into the lake. Although the dazzling light broke through the water surface that looked like a mirror did not have even the slightest ripple. Instead, it was simply cut open, as if the waves were split. A complex substance such as water could actually be split in an instant. Yet the momentum of the Shura Knife was not affected in any way and continued straight into the bottom of the lake. Ah! Suddenly, a scream could be heard but it quickly disappeared. The Supreme Demon squinted his eyes slightly, staring into the lake. After a while, a large puddle of red started floating from underwater up to the surface, slowly spreading out. It didn't take long before half the lake was covered with blood. The Supreme Demon's pupil contracted. Turning his palm, the person underwater floated up in the next moment. However, that person had a pale face and was clenching his teeth. His previously sparkling silver tail had half its scales cut off and had a deep wound with fresh blood dyeing half his body red. The Supreme Demon simply stared at the person in the water. His sculpture-like face did not have any expression at all. He said each word slowly, "Do you still wish to escape?" The Merman King only felt that the injured part of his body was so painful to the point it became numb. The pain assaulted him, spreading throughout his whole body. The pain was so torturous that he'd rather die. Unfortunately, his mind was very clear and he couldn't even faint. The Supreme Demon's words sounded far away yet close at the same time, seemingly vague yet clear at the same time. The words reverberated in his ears. For a moment, he couldn't understand what those words meant. Finally, the Merman King clenched his teeth and bore the pain. Returning back to his senses, the Merman King forced a smile. He spoke in a rough voice, I'm not your. The supreme demon's expression sank and his eyes flashed coldly. He said slowly, I will give you another chance. The merman king turned his head strenuously to look at his eyes, giving him a shallow smile. If you continue being like this, it will make me think that you have fallen in love with me. Panting for a moment, he continued exhaustingly, if that's not the case, you should let me leave. Seeing that the supreme demon was not making any movements, the merman king smiled. Enduring the pain, he swam towards the shore with great difficulty, leaving a trail of red behind him. The supreme demon silently watched as that person swam towards the shore with clenched teeth, remaining expressionless. He saw that person's body stained with blood, with fresh blood dripping continuously, yet he never looked back. He lifted his body up with arduousness and went ashore. The supreme demon hands suddenly clenched, then relaxed. In the next moment, a dazzling light from the shore, a knife that he was holding, entered his dark eyes. A flash of lightning cut through the deep night, and a frightening shock fanned out in all four directions. However, what was louder than this thunderous sound was an extremely powerless yet extremely tragic, miserable scream. Ah, only the first half of the scream could be heard. As if the scream used up all of its owner's strength, it was unknown whether the second half of the scream was not audible or if was it covered by loud water splash. The waves gradually calmed down and no more sounds could be heard. It was as if that heart-wrenching half-scream was just an illusion. The supreme demon silently watched as the glint from the shura knife illuminated the remaining scales of the person that flew up into the sky. Then he watched silently as that person's body was half ashore once again and sank deeply into the water. He silently watched as big puddles of red started rising up to the water surface once again, as if red lotuses were blooming on the water surface. For some unknown reason, at that moment, his heart suddenly calmed down. It calmed to the point where there was almost no sound. He stood quietly at the waterside, staring at the puddle of blood that was enlarging, almost covering the whole lake. He waited quietly, waiting for that person to float up from the water whom seemed to be imprisoned by the blood. For a while, for another while and yet another while, the red continued spreading endlessly, yet that person did not float up. The shura knife silently fell onto the ground. It was as if the supreme demon took great efforts to lift his hands as his golden sleeves were slightly trembling. His palm suddenly turned. The water in the lake started flooding outwards, waves after wave, as if a blood-red brocade was stretching out. Within the brocade, there was someone whose clothes were redder than blood. Yet his face was extremely pale, like that of a dead person. His long eyelashes were still and his eyes were closed. His expression looked calm, as if he was sleeping and he would no longer wake up again. The supreme demon was stunned for a moment, then he rushed over. His foot was slightly beneath the water. Rolling his sleeves, that person was already in his arms. His hair was wet and his fishtail was bloodied. His face was calm and a pale white. The body that was beautiful in the past had softened down with one with no trace of anger. A trace of panic emerged and held his heart, slowly clenching it. Yet a voice reverberated in his ears, he is the merman king and must have strong spiritual powers. Although having his scales cut off was painful, could it really affect him? Based on the situation, that person must be acting in order to escape from him. The supreme demon's hand that was holding onto the other person's hand suddenly tightened. However, his other hand involuntarily trembled and placed itself on that person's white wrist. He put his finger in place. Emptiness. There was actually no trace of spiritual power. Also, it was calm under his fingers. There was no pulse at all. At that moment, the trace of panic within his heart expanded like crazy. Like a spreading vine, it tightly winded around him, as if depriving him of air. So, he hugged the person tightly as if trying to merge with that person. The supreme demon trembled for the first time. Chapter 48, when he finally chanced upon someone bad-mouthing him, he had become a temptress expert at climbing onto someone. Not long after, An Yaihing and An Yaz were surrounded by other guests. Su Jian wasn't really interested in accompanying An Yaz to greet the guests while putting up a dignified image. An Yaz saw that he looked tired. Then he recalled Su Jian saying that he was tired of wearing high heels. Thus, he specially told Su Jian to take a break. Naturally, Su Jian obeyed immediately. He cut through the crowd in a dignified manner and escaped elegantly. He first found some snacks to fill his stomach. Then, he found a corner to sit down and rest quietly. The corner didn't have much lighting, so it was darker. Also, there weren't many people there, so he didn't try to act anymore. He secretly removed his high heels and then sat down on the railing. Leaning against the railing, he looked at the faintly lighted banquet hall. Many people were dressed gorgeously, gathering to drink. Though it looked lively there, it was actually a bit tiring, whether it is due to the clothes and shoes they were wearing or the smile they were carrying. Su Jian silently complained in his heart, it seems like being a rich man isn't easy as well. If he turns rich in the future and becomes a rich man, he would hold a party as well. At that time, he would make a rule to ban everyone from wearing formal attire. The males had to wear tank tops, underpants, and large slippers, while the females would have to wear night dresses and small sandals. There wouldn't be any champagne and wine as well, but hot pots, cold noodles, mala soup, spicy Chinese hamburger, stinky tofu, hand grab cake, spicy duck neck, sauce trotters, and etc. for them to choose. No elegant piano or violin pieces for music either. Instead, everyone would be entertained by songs such as Little Apple, Most Dazzling Folk Style, and Don't Pick the Roadside Wildflowers. Additionally, he'd invite famous celebrities as well. However, when Jian arrived, he wouldn't let her sing her masterpiece I Know You Will Always Love Me. When Yi Lang arrived, he wouldn't let Yi Lang perform his classic dance I Am Me as well. He'd definitely make the both of them wear a small flower jacket, hold a red handkerchief, and perform Dong Bo Renzhuan. Su Jian thought about his dream Richmond party affectionately. His heart had a sudden longing. While he was deeply immersed in his thoughts, the sound of a few people talking suddenly entered his ears. I feel that woman isn't even really worth anything. Why did third young master fall for her? I think so too. She has no family background and she seems narrow-minded. Yet, she was actually able to climb onto the Yin family. I wonder how much efforts she put in. Maybe she is very skillful in some other areas? Don't you think so? Haha, that's true. Just look at how she was clinging onto the third young master's body like a temptress. It was the voice of a few women. Although the volume was purposely lowered, Su Jian was not that far away so he could still hear quite a bit of their conversation. Initially, Su Jian was at a loss as he didn't know who that bunch of ladies was talking about. However, he started to understand. Climb onto the Yin family, third young master's woman, weren't all of these descriptions of himself? This was the first time he had chanced upon the dark side of others and Su Jian was feeling completely awkward. In the past, what he wished the most was that someone would point at his nose one day and scold him, what else do you have other than money? Yet, he would have never expected that when he finally chanced upon someone bad-mouthing him, he had become a temptress expert at climbing onto someone. Su Jian couldn't help but touch his own face. Then, he looked at his bare foot that was resting in exhaustion. No matter how hard he tried, he couldn't link himself with the word temptress. The conversation over there was still not over. No matter how I look at her, I still feel that Ning Su is better. Hey, comparing Ning Su with that woman, aren't you belittling Ning Su? Ning Su is so pretty. She graduated from a famous school, knows three languages, and can play five different instruments. Can that woman even compare? I'm not as great as how all of you are saying. There was actually someone familiar in there. Hearing Bai Ning Su's voice, Su Jian felt a little awful. To think that there would be a day when his beauty would be compared to a girl, life sure was full of surprises. Su Jian abused himself by perking up his ears, wanting to hear more. However, ever since someone else came over, the bunch of ladies no longer made more any sounds. Su Jian waited for a while more, but there were still no voices. Thinking that those dark people had left, he came down from the railing in disappointment. Returning back to the brighter areas, Su Jian once again worked hard to look dignified. Then, he remembered the dark people comments about him being a temptress. He wanted to try acting out that role seriously. Unfortunately, he had no idea how he could portray himself like that magical word. Su Jian looked around. He saw An Yaz still talking within the crowd of guests. He turned back his head and pondered. Then, he picked up a cup of juice obediently and drank a mouthful of it. Looking up, He happened to see Jian close by. He suddenly remembered about the autograph. When he wanted to get the photos, he heard someone calling him. "Miss Su." Su Jian was startled. "This voice sounds familiar." Su Jian looked over and saw a young woman dressed exquisitely standing in front of him. Not far behind her, Bei Ning Su and another woman were also looking over. The woman's laughter was very dignified and elegant, with no trace of contempt like before. She glanced at an Yaz that wasn't far away and praised, "Third young master is young and promising. Miss Su is gentle and virtuous. The two of you are a pair made by heaven." Su Jian felt that it was absurd. He cursed in his heart. "Dear, I remembered you calling me a temptress just a moment ago. Why are you being so gentle and virtuous now? Did you have to change so quickly?" Fortunately, Su Jian still looked calm on the surface. He laughed. "Gently and virtuously, thank you." The woman continued, "Miss Su and third young master's relationship is so good. It is enviable." Su Jian continued, "Being gentle and virtuous, that should be the case." "Woman." After exchanging a few words of courtesy, the woman suddenly said, "I have heard that Miss Su can play three different instruments. Today is third young master's birthday. How about playing a piece as a present for third young master? I'm sure third young master would be very happy." Su Jian understood everything immediately. The words "gentle and virtuous" that was said earlier wasn't just for courtesy. Looks like he had to pay the price for those words now. Three different instruments. Why did he not know that he had such an ability? Since young, he was sure he only knew how to play one musical instrument, and that was whistling. He was very talented in this area. When he was in university, he whistled frequently and could whistle to the point that his brothers felt like peeing. Su Jian had wanted to confess that he couldn't play an instrument, but he saw Bei Ning Su walking over. Her voice and expression were both gentle. "Coincidentally, there is a piano here. Brother Yaz likes to play the piano too. If he hears Miss Su playing for him, I'm sure he will be very happy." "I don't know if he will be happy or not, but I will definitely not be happy," Su Jian said honestly. "Actually, I don't know how to play the piano." The woman started laughing. "Miss Su is being modest. Within family's family status, how is it possible for the woman that is married into their family to not even know how to play the piano?" "Su Jian, your mom. Nowadays you actually need to check a woman's piano grade before marrying her." He had long known that finding a job was hard. One needed to have at least a grade 2 in the National Computer Rank Examination, pass the SIT 4 and SIT 6 exam, and one sufficient knowledge for their job. However, he did not know that he actually needed a grade to marry as well. Life was so hard at this point. In the midst of feeling absurd, a gentle voice interrupted them. "All of you should stop making things difficult for Miss Su, or else Xiao's heart will ache." Su Jian looked up and saw Queen Ji standing before him with a gentle smile, her eyes full of good intentions. Bei Ning Su smiled sweetly. "Then why not Sister Ji play a piece for Brother Yaz? I have heard that Sister Ji's good at playing the piano. You also have a good relationship with Brother Yaz. If he hears Sister Ji's playing, Brother Yaz might be even happier." Jian laughed. "How could I as a guest overwhelm the host's limelight? Although I grew up together with Xiao's, it is Xiao's birthday party today. Miss Su should of course hold the authority." Turning around, she said to Su Jian, "So what if you can play the piano or not? Xiao's didn't marry you for the fact that you can play the piano." The woman at the side added, "Miss Ji's right. It's okay even if you can't play the piano. Maybe Miss Su wishes to play some other instrument? Coincidentally, there is a band that has been specially invited and they have most of the common instruments. Miss Su may wish to see which instrument you like." "I don't like any of them." Su Jian did not expect that he would be targeted by someone about playing an instrument today. He suddenly felt helpless. "Say, why is nobody asking whether I can sing or not? I'm good at pop songs, folk songs, and even children's songs." While he was confused, his waist was suddenly hot as a familiar hand embraced it. An Yaz who appeared suddenly looked down towards him and said faintly, "Today is my birthday. If everyone wishes to hear the piano, it should naturally be me playing." While saying that, he held Su Jian's hand. Under the eyes of everyone, he walked step by step towards the black piano. His words were for everyone. However, His eyes hid a trace of smile as he glanced at Su Jian, who obviously breathed out a sigh of relief. But I would like to apologize. The piece I am playing is not meant for everyone but for my wife. Chapter 49, Third Sister-in-Law. Third brother just confessed to you. Why aren't you treating him better? The crowd gradually quieted down. The people were all wearing different expressions. However, all of them were looking towards the two people beside the piano. An Yai's looked at Su Jian quietly. Placing his long slender fingers on the black and white piano keys, he pressed them down. Brisk notes slowly flowed out. They were soft yet clear, sounding pleasant and soothing. Su Jian could not tell what music piece it was. He just felt that it sounded pretty nice. The music from the piano was like flowing water, slowly flowing to every corner of the hall, flowing into the summer night where the flowers were still blooming. Everyone kept quiet as they silently listened. Many different kinds of moods were evoked within each and person's eyes. However, Su Jian kept staring at An Yaz's hands. He had never noticed before, but An Yaz's hands were actually quite beautiful. Although it could compare to a woman's soft and smooth hands, his long slender fingers and the slightly visible veins at the back of his hands made his hands look clean. When it landed nimbly on the black and white piano keys, an inexplicable sexiness could be felt from it. When he realized the meaning of the word sexiness, Su Jian felt that he was struck by lightning. To actually feel that a man's hand was sexy, and it was actually this fellow An Yaz's hand. He must have been too tired tonight, that's why all his descriptions were coming out wrong. Su Jian looked up immediately. His side left An Yaz's hands and landed on An Yaz's face. However, he froze once again. An Yaz's expression didn't change much when he played the piano. It was plain as usual. But at that moment, under the lighting, the image of that man dressed in a suit, with eyes looking downwards, playing the piano with great concentration, seemed to have attracted all the light around him. The other areas seemed to have dimmed down and all the light landed on his head. A ray of light quietly shone down onto his body. Su Jian thought involuntarily, I have not noticed this before, but An Yaz's eyelashes are actually pretty long. An Yaz, who was playing, halfway looked up at Su Jian and realized that he seemed to be in a daze. A smile could not help but form on his lips. The little girl was standing quietly beside the piano, coincidentally blocked all his vision. From his angle, he could only see her face that was slightly against the light. A few strands of lightly curled hair landed on the side of her lips. The lip gloss at the side of her lip was slightly rubbed off, revealing the familiar color of her soft lips. And within her clear eyes, there seemed to be a moving light. He didn't know if it was his shadow that laid within the depth of her eyes or, behind her, there were still many other guests. However, she could only see him. As for how she looked like at this moment, he was the only one that could see that as well. Under his fingers, the musical notes were still jumping slowly. Despite that, in An Yaz's heart, there was a quiet sense of satisfaction. A long, long time ago, he was also sitting before the piano like this, practicing it day after day, playing it year after year. What he wished for was simply to play a piece for her, the one who said that he was a little prince. He had waited for so long, but that time never came. And now, he was no longer a little prince. Yet, he did not expect that when he played the piano again, he would have his rose now. The last note faded like water. However, the smooth and brisk music seemed to linger and move in the air. The crowd started clapping slowly. Despite that, An Yaz only looked up towards Su Jian, his eyes containing a trace of a smile. He asked in a low and gentle voice, does it sound nice? Su Jian nodded his head honestly. Very nice. An Yaz's lips expanded with a smile. He rarely had such an obvious smile. Therefore, it wasn't only the guests who were surprised. Even Su Jian couldn't control himself and gave him a few more glances. An Yaz asked, what's wrong? Su Jian shook his head while feeling sour in his heart. When this in person smiles and reveals his teeth, he is actually. No wonder he could attract so many girls. An Yaz stood up and held his hand. He nodded towards everyone else, then left the piano side with him. Third young master is so good at playing the piano. They only walked a few steps before a dark person by the side suddenly spoke. An Yaz paused his footsteps and said thank you in a distant yet polite way. When he wanted to continue walking, The dark person suddenly smiled at Su Jian. Third young master gave Miss Su such a big gift. Shouldn't Miss Su give a return gift? Such persistence. This dark person is actually very good at putting up a fight. Su Jian suddenly felt that he shouldn't waste this dark person's efforts. Hence, when Yaz furrowed his brows and wanted to say something, Su Jian lightly pulled the hand that was holding his hand. He then said with a smile, "What this miss said is correct. Yaz, I will perform something as well. Take it as my appreciation for you playing the piano." Yaz was hesitating whether to stop her if he suggested singing when Su Jian asked the housekeeper over and gave a few instructions. After the housekeeper left, he then turned over and said to Yaz, "Watch me perform a magic trick." Yaz's eyebrows rose. He said with a gentle voice, "Okay." After a while, the housekeeper got the deck of cards that Su Jian wanted. A few days ago, he saw a custom-made anime decks online, so he ordered two sets of it. Other than admiring it, he would sometimes take them out to practice a few magic tricks that he knew before his rebirth. Originally, it was a little game meant for him to kill some time when he was bored. Surprisingly, he would actually be using them today. Su Jian opened the box and took out the cards. A trace of surprise appeared in Yaz's eyes when he saw his neat shuffling action. The magic trick was actually pretty simple, to guess the card. Nevertheless, for ordinary people that had never practiced before, it was quite magical. After performing neatly and perfectly, he looked at Yaz. Yaz smiled when he saw the small sense of pride in his eyes. Su Jian automatically took his smile as a compliment and felt happy in his heart. Thus, he neatly slid open the cards in his hands. One card flew out cleverly and he passed it to Yaz. Yaz took it and looked at it. On the poker card, there was a gray wolf with a large bag on his head, its expression looking very forced. Yaz. Then, another card flew out. He politely passed the card to the dark person and smiled. "For you." The dark person took the card hesitantly. Turning the card over, she saw a bald head grinning very creepily. The dark person, Yaz, held Su Jian's hand and brought her away. The couple were talking about something with one of them lowering his head while the other raised her head. The man lowering his head had eyes that were full of doting. The woman raising her head had a bright smile. When the dark person saw this, she could no longer cover up her face and it darkened. She whispered in hatred, "What magic trick? How is it decent? Looks like she is only an entertainer." At the side, Jian heard those words and her complexion sank slightly. She had yet to open her mouth when a low and magnetic voice suddenly sounded behind the dark person. "I'm also an entertainer. It looks like Miss Li is not happy with us entertainers." The dark person turned around in shock and saw Yaying standing behind her, looking at her with a faint smile. The dark person froze. Then, her face slowly reddened. Her hasty voice had a trace of shyness. "Second young master, that's not what I meant. Actually, I'm your fan." Su Jian followed Yaz only for a short distance before being stopped by Yiru, asking him to teach her the small magic trick. Yaz saw the situation and let him go. However, he specifically told him not to consume alcohol. Su Jian replied with a stare, "Yes, Uncle Yaz." As she saw her brother walking away with a wooden face, Yiru laughed. "Third sister-in-law, third brother just confessed to you. Why aren't you treating him better?" "Confessed?" Su Jian was shocked, then he felt flabbergasted. "When did that happen?" "When he was playing the piano." Yiru smiled and said, "Didn't third brother play Dreams of Love? He said that it was meant for you. He was obviously confessing to you." Su Jian gradually calmed down and thought in his heart, "Girl, you're thinking too much. Your brother and I are purely business partners that sleep on the same bed. Your third brother can play Dreams of Love or Song of Pig for all I care, but those are just for showing off his piano skills." Finding a corner, he taught Yiru for a while. Feeling thirsty, he asked the maid for a cup of juice. Then, he suddenly remembered that he had yet to ask for the autograph. Thus, he quickly found the plastic bag with Jian's photo and started looking for Jian. However, after searching around, he still couldn't find Jian's figure. "Don't tell me Queen Ji has left." Su Jian was not going to give up and started searching all around. Then, He happened to chance upon a maid. The maid told him that she might have seen Jian heading towards the swimming pool.
Swimming pool? Su Jian couldn't understand. Although the weather was hot, it was already so late in the night. Was Queen Ji really going to swim? Wouldn't that be too into the mood?
With his head full of doubt, Su Jian walked towards the swimming pool. Turning past a bush, he inadvertently looked up and suddenly stared with large eyes.
Wait. If he was not wrong, that tall and slim female beside the pool was Jian. But the male beside her dot wasn't he his husband, uncle An?
Why are they not staying in the lively banquet hall, but instead going to a desolate swimming pool?
This is abnormal. There must be some gossip material.
Su Jian's heart was full of curiosity.
The gossiping antenna on his head stood up immediately.
Pondering for a moment, he removed his high heels. He walked barefooted towards the two of them with hunched back.
There happened to be a flower bush beside the swimming pool.
There was no light illuminating that corner, so it was a perfect hiding place for someone to eavesdrop.
Su Jian stationed himself there discourteously.
Perking up his ears, he started listening in on their conversation.
The sparkling lights at the swimming pool casted a blurred shadow onto Jian's face.
Her voice had a trace of blurred dejection.
"Xiao's, I didn't expect for you to marry so soon."
Yaz replied.
"Me too."
Jian's voice was very light.
"I always wondered what kind of woman you would marry. However, I have never expected that you liked this kind."
Yaz looked at her quietly. Neither joy nor sorrow could be seen in his eyes.
Jian is very good."
The smile on Jian's face paled.
"She's indeed a very cute girl."
Pausing for a moment, she looked at Yaz.
A sense of unacceptance appeared in her eyes.
"Therefore, if you don't truly love her, and you married her, it will be very unfair for her."
Yaz furrowed his eyebrows unconsciously.
He said, "Why do you think so?"
Jian smiled wryly.
"Xiao's, you are still angry with me, aren't you?
I know that you have always been angry with me for rejecting your proposal."
Behind the flower bush, Su Jian's eyes widened.
"Proposal?
Yaz proposed to Queen Ji before?
Holy shit.
This is shocking gossip material." Chapter 50, Yaz.
"Quick, sister-in-law can't swim."
Su Jian was still in the midst of his shock when he suddenly felt someone approaching him from the side.
He had a sudden shock.
He turned around quickly and saw Ji Mingfei smiling at him from within the darkness.
"It's actually gay friend Ji."
Su Jian felt quite marveled. He looked speechlessly as Ji Mingfei squatted at a comfortable spot beside him with a righteous face.
Behind the flower bush, two people who are wearing formal attire were watching the show with tacit understanding.
The conversation over there continued.
After Jian's said those shocking words,
Yaz silently replied, "No, I'm not. I truly like her."
Jian did not believe him.
"But she's still a young girl."
After a moment of silence,
Yaz replied,
"What I like about her is her pureness."
Su Jian felt awkward.
"Pureness? Fine."
Although he did feel that he was very righteous and kind since he respected the old and loved the young, he still felt awkward being described as pure by Yaz.
He even said, "What I like about her is her pureness."
Yaz,
you finally exposed yourself?
Looks like you really are into this.
A 30-year-old uncle liking a pure young woman. It seems that an uncle loving lullaby is eternal.
Ji Mingfei heard Yaz's words and immediately gave a silent thumbs up.
Initially, Su Jian was worried that Ji Mingfei would be sad.
After all, Ji Mingfei probably had feelings for Yaz.
First, he heard that Yaz had proposed to Jian before.
Then, in just a short moment, he heard Yaz saying that he liked himself.
How could Ji Mingfei, who was infatuated, not be hurt?
Unexpectedly, when he turned around, he saw Ji Mingfei's face full of excitement.
Su Jian immediately relaxed.
In his heart, he thought, "That's right.
So what if he had proposed?
Wasn't he rejected?
So what if he likes me?
It's just Yaz is acting to show affection.
Therefore, gay friend Ji, you still have a good chance."
Over on that side, after hearing Yaz's words, Jian's face slightly paled.
However, she was still concerned.
"However, does she really like you?
I've heard that her family background isn't great."
"What if she is aiming for your family background?"
Su Jian felt depressed.
Although Jian said it in a roundabout way,
He understood the meaning behind her words very clearly. Isn't she saying that he married an Yaz for an Yaz's money? The way Queen Ji's acting is clearly trying to break an Yaz and him apart. Su Jian quietly asked Ji Mingfei, "Is Jian marrying that Li whatever soon?" Ji Mingfei nodded his head. "Yes, Li's family second young master, Li Minyai." With this, Su Jian couldn't understand anymore. Jian was going to be married soon. Previously, she said that she rejected An Yaz's proposal. Now that An Yaz was married, why was she still coming here to persuade him otherwise? Say, what is she doing this for? Su Jian was so confused, his small face was all scrunched up. Maybe Queen Ji hated him, so she felt that he was not suitable for An Yaz. Maybe in her eyes, he was just a greedy person that was aiming for An Yaz's family wealth. Su Jian was a little unhappy, because he really did love An Yaz only for his money. Over at that side, after hearing her words, An Yaz's voice lowered. "Jian, Jian is not such a person." Jian's voice was very gentle and contained the perfect amount of concern. "You can't be so sure about whether she is or not now. You have only known her for a short while, right? I don't remember you talking about her before." An Yaz didn't say anything. Jian looked at him with a very sincere expression. With a gentle voice, she said, "Xiaos, I'm just being concerned about you, because I wish for you to gain real happiness. I don't want you to be hurt." An Yaz slowly said, "Whether I'm happy or not is the same as drinking water. I will be able to feel the coldness or warmth the water brings myself." Jian smiled wryly. "Xiaos, are you blaming me for butting into your business? I always thought we are best friends." "No, I'm not." An Yaz continued, "But Jian, you are indeed thinking too much. I'm doing great now, because of Jian. Jian, I finally understand what is happiness." "Really?" Jian's smile started to look a bit forceful. "You really dot love her?" An Yaz nodded his head. "Yes, I love her." Dot. Listening up to this point, Ji Mingfei hooked up his lips in satisfaction. However, when he turned around to look at Su Jian, he saw Su Jian scrunching up his face, wearing a weird expression. Su Jian had never expected to hear those words from An Yaz. He couldn't help but feel strange. Although he knew An Yaz said that to show affection, when he heard An Yaz say that he loved him, he still felt fascinated. Previously, he had once imagined the scene of An Yaz telling him, "I love you." Right now, the real version wasn't as sensational as the one he had imagined. An Yaz wasn't speaking to him directly. An Yaz's tone was also flat. However, he felt slightly moved in his heart, and that was stronger than before. An Yaz's words sounded very real. In his life, he had never heard the girls say that they loved him. Yet, he had just heard a man say that he loved him. Although those were just fake lines for acting, when he heard it, he felt strange and embarrassed. At this moment, Ji Mingfei suddenly tapped him and whispered, "Sister-in-law, didn't you want her autograph? You can go for it now." Su Jian looked at the two people in front. When he saw the two of them not speaking for a while, he stood up secretly. As Ji Mingfei saw that, he followed him towards the other two as well. Su Jian acted like he saw them by accident and walked towards the two of them. When An Yaz saw him, he was a little surprised. Then he looked up towards Ji Mingfei, who was at the back. Ji Mingfei returned his look with a bright smile. An Yaz asked, "Jian, Jian, why are you here?" Su Jian asked in return, "Then why are you here?" An Yaz replied, "I was speaking with Jian." Su Jian looked at him mockingly and replied with a meaningful "oh." An Yaz was a little speechless. Looking downwards, he saw him barefoot and couldn't help but furrow his brows. "Why are you barefooted?" Su Jian then realized that he had forgotten to wear his heels just now and had come out barefooted. Although he didn't need to mind it in front of An Yaz, there was an outsider here right now. Su Jian felt awkward. Wanting to wear the heels, he bent his back downwards. With one hand, An Yaz took away the heels that he was holding in his hand. Squatting naturally, An Yaz held his ankle and carefully helped him put on the heels. Su Jian was a little stunned. He thought, An Yaz sure knows how to keep things going, not sparing any chance to show his acting skills. Pondering for a moment, he cooperated and said sweetly, "Hubby, you're so nice." An Yaz's hand that was holding onto his ankle silently paused. After An Yaz stood up, Su Jian hugged one of his arms cheerfully. Then, He looked at Guiyan, whose face was slightly pale, and said politely, "Queen Ji, may I have your autograph?" Saying so, he passed the bag with Jian's photos to her. "There's a pen inside." Ji Mingfei, who was on the side, gave Jian a glance and his lips hooked up slightly. Jian stared at the girl in front of her, who was sweetly hugging Yaz's arm. She had a well-behaved and tender look. When she smiled, she looked sweet. However, no matter how Jian looked at her, she only had the look of an ordinary girl next door. The girl was leaning onto the tall and calm man's body in a petite and lovely manner. The light and soft white yarn dress and the black suits by the side formed a dazzling harmony. When she saw that, Jian pursed her lips. She stayed silent for a moment before she stretched out her hand to take the bag that the other person was passing to her. Moving her eyes away to stop looking at the two people in front, Jian slowly took the photo out from the bag. However, in the next moment, her expression stiffened. She thought that it was her photo was inside. When she took them out, however, it was actually a photo of a man and a woman standing next to each other. And this man and woman were Yaz and Su Jian, who were right in front of her. Yaz and Su Jian saw the photo as well. Yaz raised his eyebrows and immediately turned over to look at Ji Mingfei. Ji Mingfei looked at him with a natural smile. Previously, when Su Jian asked Ji Mingfei to tell the housekeeper to print the photos, Ji Mingfei had purposely changed some of Su Jian's words when he passed the message on. He didn't touch Yi Lang's photo. However, instead of printing Jian's photo as Su Jian wanted, he asked the housekeeper to print photos of An Yaz together with Su Jian. Su Jian whispered to An Yaz in surprise, "Hey, when did we take this photo?" An Yaz replied, "Before you lost your memories." Su Jian immediately understood. The two of them probably needed to trick the outsiders, so they specially took some photos together. After all, they were supposed to be a loving couple. It would be very suspicious if they only had a marriage certificate but no photos of them together. But why did this photo pop up from the bag? Did the housekeeper uncle make a mistake? Su Jian looked at Ji Mingfei with an inquiring gaze. Ji Mingfei understood his doubts and explained, "The housekeeper probably misheard. But that's good too. If Miss Ji signs the photo of the two of you, it can be seen as her giving her blessing to the two of you for your marriage." After he finished speaking, he turned around to look at Jian. "Miss Ji, what do you think?" Jian's mouth twitched. Without saying anything, she slowly picked up the photo and started signing. Who knew that when she finished signing one, there was another one below? The photo was still the same, showing the smiling faces of An Yaz and Su Jian, who were dependent on each other. Su Jian quickly said, "There are 10 photos in total. I'm troubling you." Although An Yaz seemed to be close with Jian, it still wasn't as close as An Yaz's relationship with An Yaiheng. If not, based on his real intentions, he would have printed 200 photos. Jian silently signed the 10 photos before passing them to Su Jian. Su Jian let go of An Yaz's arm and went forward to take the photos. Unexpectedly, his high heels suddenly slid out. An Yaz had wanted to grab him. However, he did not expect that Ji Mingfei would also stretch his arm over. Jian passed the photos in her hands to Su Jian, and the two of their hands touched. While Su Jian was staggering, Jian's hands suddenly moved forward. Su Jian, who wasn't stable in the first place, started slipping. His body slanted backwards and he started falling into the pool behind him. During this desperate situation, Su Jian was anxious to save himself. When he touched Jian's hand in his panic, he immediately pulled it strongly. Splash, splash. Loud splashes sounded. After exclaiming, both Su Jian and Jian fell into the swimming pool. Ji Mingfei was instantly shocked. He said hurriedly, "Yaz, quick, sister-in-law can't swim." His voice was very loud. Even Su Jian, who was submerged in water, could faintly hear it. While suffocated, Su Jian dazedly cursed, "I know how to swim. While we were chatting the last time, I even mentioned it to you." "Gay friend Ji, your memory is so bad." But very quickly, Su Jian could no longer curse. "Your mom. Why am I having a leg cramp at such a time? Shit, it hurts." Unable to control himself, Su Jian opened his mouth. Water started rushing in immediately. Above the water, Ji Mingfei had yet to speak and An Yaz had already started jumping into the water. Beneath the water, Jian and Su Jian were both sinking. Seeing him enter the water,
Jian stretched out her hand strenuously.
However, An Yaz did not see that at all. That was because he was horrified to see that after a moment of struggling, Su Jian, who wasn't far away, gradually stopped moving and started sinking into the water unconscious. An Yaz's heart suddenly jumped and he swam over vigorously. He held Su Jian's hand and pulled him into his embrace before holding onto his waist and swam back with great efforts. Appearing above the water, An Yaz hugged Su Jian and swam towards the side of the pool. Jim Mingfei, who was there, immediately brought Su Jian up. Su Jian had already fainted. When Jim Mingfei saw that, he was stunned. He quickly started checking, but An Yaz had already come back up with the help of the poolside. He hugged Su Jian and laid him horizontally over his kneeling legs. Then, he started pressing Su Jian's back. Jim Mingfei could only retreat to one side. Seeing Su Jian's closed eyes and An Yaz's cold face, he couldn't help but feel regretful. At this moment, Jian had also swum out. Jim Mingfei caught a glimpse of it and stretched out his hand to pull her up. Jian's whole body felt uncomfortable and her face was pale white. Trembling, she cried out, "Xiaos!" Coincidentally, Su Jian suddenly choked out a mouth of water. Immediately, An Yaz asked in concern, "Jian, Jian?" After spitting out a few mouths of water, he gradually regained his breath. His eyelids moved and he slowly opened his eyes. He called out softly, "Yaz." An Yaz's heart clenched, then it relaxed. He gave a short reply and suddenly carried Su Jian up from his horizontal position. He turned around and the fully drenched Jian immediately walked forward. "Yaz." An Yaz paused. Jim Mingfei immediately said, "Yaz, you should send sister-in-law to a doctor first." "I will take care of Miss Jian," An Yaz replied with an N. He nodded at Jian before carrying Su Jian away in large strides.